The views and opinions expressed on this program are those of the participants and do not reflect the views of BronxNet or the program underwriters.
BronxNet. Your voice, your views, your vision.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Open. Open is the show where we bring you the best in the Bronx, New York, and the world straight to you. All in the best in art, music, entertainment, sports, and much, much more. That's coming your way today and every Friday. I'm Frida Valentin, your Café con Leche, and host for the next hour. We will get this weekend off to an amazing start with some fun events in our Open Weekend Preview, and then the best in Latin news in our Latin trends, top tweet of the week is in again, and El Amigo Duende is a new play opening soon, and we've got the star here to give us a taste, and Hostos is the home of the New York Latin Music Awards, and you won't want to miss that. And of course, the inside scoop on the Yankees East Division win with Bobby C's Sports Roundup and our Open Artist Spotlight was a bit of a bombero flavor this week, so stay tuned. All that and more headed your way, because now we are officially open. We have a jam-packed show ahead, but please remember that we are live and interactive, and you know, we love hearing from our viewers. So if you have any questions, comments, suggestions, you actually can send us an email to open@bronxnet.org, and send us any comments on past episodes by going to bronxnet.org/TV/open. And you know, we are on the social networks, people. So hit us up at Facebook @openbronxnettelevision. And of course, you can leave us a comment there, and on Twitter too, @BronxNetTV, that would be. And while you're there, follow me @RinaValentin. All right, let's get right into it. The Open Weekend Preview is right back in the beginning at the top of the show. And that, well, let's see what there is to do. First up, Frankie Morales and his Mambo of the Times Orchestra. Ooh, Frankie Morales and his Mambo of the Times Orchestra and A.E.M.A.S. will perform at Side Street this Columbus Day weekend. So stop by and enjoy the Latin stylings. That's happening on Saturday, October 6th, and the doors open at 9 p.m. Side Street is located at 1332 Blondell Avenue in the Bronx. And for more info, you can go to www.sidestreetlounge.com. Next, we have Festival de la Palabra, or Festival of Words. In honor of Hispanic Heritage Month, Lehman College and Hostos Community College will co-sponsor the annual Puerto Rican Festival de la Palabra. The San Juan, Puerto Rico-based writers' festival attracts thousands of admirers while also highlighting Puerto Rican wordsmiths. The festival's writers will be visiting Hostos Community College on October 10th and Lehman College on October 11th. And for more on the events at Lehman and Hostos, including excerpts of the writings, you can visit www.lehman.cuny.edu/academics/FBLP-PHEND. I hope you had a pen for that one. And so, finally, we have Pepa Tian's 30th anniversary fundraiser at the Bruckner Bar and Grill. The South Bronx-based nonprofit organization is celebrating its 30th anniversary in 2013 with a fundraiser on Tuesday, October 9th from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. at the Bruckner Bar and Grill. The evening will include presentations and performances by acclaimed artists and will be hosted by MC Majora Carter. The buffet dinner is also included, and to RSVP, and for more information, you can go to papatiana.org. The Bruckner Bar and Grill, by the way, can be found at 1 Bruckner Boulevard in the Bronx. So, mi gente, get out there and enjoy. Check out some of those events while the weather is still amazing. That's right. What are we in, 80 degrees today? Mm-hmm. So make sure you get out. All right. We have to take a quick break. But when we return, it'll be time for our new segment, Latin Trends Top Tweet of the Week. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
I remember how much you said you liked mine.
Oh.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of siblings in foster care who take you just as you are.
Kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
And welcome back. The Latin Trends Top Tweets of the Week, bringing you the latest update in Latin culture, cuisine, entertainment, and celebrity bochinche. That's gossip, people. So first up, let's see, we have... Okay, so we have Vanessa Verduga. She launches Justice Woman web series during Hispanic Heritage Month. Justice Woman. Didn't I hear Sotomayor tried out for that part? Let's see, number two. We have, Daddy Yankee, people. Daddy Yankee drops new video directed by Jesse Terrero. And, well, Latin Trends has the link to an exclusive behind the scenes. Yeah. So we're proud of Daddy Yankee and his achievements and his professionalism, as director Jesse Terrero said. But apparently, they were filming in Mexico near the pyramids, and they built in this sunken mud jacuzzi with models bathing in the mud. Ooh la la. So rumor has it that Daddy Yankee asked for excessive takes of that scene. Yeah. All right, so next we have casting call for The Bachelorette. Mira eso. The Bachelorette, you know ABC's Bachelorette? Well, they're looking for 25 eligible men. 25. So if you know someone who may be a great candidate to nominate, send them to bachelor.tv. I mean, you know, mi gente, this is the year of the people of color, so BX represent. Oh, espérate. I'm getting a call. Hello? Uh-huh. Well, I mean, you could submit, but I think you stand a better chance if you get a job, Tony. Yeah, but Tony, can you, like, not call me on my personal line while I'm doing the show? All right? Thank you. Sorry about that. All right, so, excuse me. Right, back to the tweets. So our last tweet is, bueno, Goya Foods donates 100,000 pounds of food to victims of Hurricane Isaac in Louisiana. So now there's this stench that has plagued Louisiana. And yeah, well, they haven't figured out where it's coming from. Right. All right, people, that was the Latin Trends Top Tweets of the Week. Tune in next week for more exciting news from the Latino landscape and LatinTrends.com, New York's official magazine and website of pop culture with a Latin twist. All right, exciting things in the Latino community, people. Be sure to follow Latin Trends on Twitter at Latin Trends. All right, so Amigo Duende is a famous Puerto Rican fairy tale, and we've got the star of the play that inspired after the break. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. Check.
Nice, Dad. Nice, Dad. Nice, Dad.
Charles!
Nice, Dad.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of siblings in foster care who'll take you just as you are.
Kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
So here are the keys.
Congratulations, it's officially yours. I'm sure you'll have many happy years here.
Except for you, because you'll be gone 3 years from now, struck down by the same disease that got your father. So you won't be around for them. And sadly, it could have been detected early with a simple test. But you didn't have it. Okay, who wants to check out the backyard?
For a list of tests every man should have, go to ahrq.gov.
G-morning, sunshine. Wakey, wakey. Text me. Are your parents home later? We can hang. LUV, love you. JK. Holla back. Holla back. Holla back.
Are you with your friends?
That's lame. We're in a huge fight right now.
XO.
What'd you dream about?
Something I did.
Are you on your way to the
mall? I'm lonely.
Nude pics. Send me some. Text me.
I'm lucky.
Let me help you with that.
I get to do something I love. It has nothing to do with touchdowns or titles.
Everybody bring it in.
I get to play a part in the life of someone just starting out.
How many of you think homework is just as important as teamwork?
I help keep kids in school.
Good.
And that's the name of the game.
My name is LaDainian Thomason. I don't just wear the shirt. I live it.
Give. Advocate. Volunteer. Live United.
Hello, welcome back to Open. Rina Valentin here, and there is a new play premiering at El Museo del Barrio this weekend. And to tell us how they brought a fairy tale to life on the stage, we have Javier Gomez on set. Javier is not one of the actors. He's actually the actor spokesperson because the actors are where? On stage. So please, it must be interesting to be their spokesperson and speak as if though you were them regarding the show.
Well, it's been really a fascinating experience to do Amigo Duende. It's really been a labor of love. Amigo Duende is a big musical play with a big heart. It is produced by Revolución Latina, the not-for-profit founded by Latino Broadway actors to do community work, and this is one of their initiative to a secure accessibility to families and children, and okay, bring theater directly right into our neighborhoods.
So let's just back up a little bit and just share with everybody who Revolución Latina is. And even though you just said that they're part of this organization of Latinos on Broadway, what they do so that our audience understands what Amigo Duende represents.
Absolutely. Revolución Latina was founded by a group of very prominent Latino actors on Broadway, Luis Salgado, Gabriela García, from all Hispanic backgrounds.
Who happen to be in the Heights.
Happen to be in the Heights. They're Dominicanos, they're Puerto Rican, Mexican, a big, beautiful rainbow of them. And what they do is that they bring arts and education programs into our schools and community centers, many of them in the Bronx. And they also have an annual Broadway summer camp for children, and they also have a series of training workshops for emerging artists. Now, part of their educational platform, it's also about productions, making productions that really come into our neighborhoods and really bring theater, arts, and live performance to communities that are underserved and underrepresented. Amigo Duende, this new musical that is playing this weekend at El Museo, is one of those programs.
Now, just to share with everyone, Amigo Duende, the word Duende is the elf, right? So it's the elf friend, and it's just interesting that the show would revolve around an elf. Like, why an elf?
Well, the story is based on the classic Puerto Rican fairy tale about this six-year-old girl who, on the eve of her first day of school, must make a very big choice. Does she give up her life of dreams and adventures with her imaginary friend, an elf, or does she become a big girl. And she goes to school and she forgets about those worlds of fantasy. Basically, the show teaches us how to grow up while also embracing our inner child and never losing that essence of innocence and enthusiasm and awe toward the world and wonder toward the world.
I get what you're saying. It's almost like finding balance.
Absolutely.
Right? Because when you get older, you kind of tend to lose the imagination component to, you know, what it is.
Which is funny because also in Spanish language, the word duende is also a wordplay for sort of soul, essence as well.
Oh, interesting.
The little duende in you.
Right. Nice. That's nice. That's nice. That's nice. Now, this is a musical, and it's got a full cast, right? So share a little bit about what people should expect, because this is only for this weekend. And so we want to make sure that you guys get the gist of how, this is being offered in your backyard and how important it is for you to get out, even without kids. So give us a little just insight of what the amount of cast it involves and just how long the show is and what people should expect.
Only for this weekend in celebration of Hispanic Heritage Month is a cast of 18 people on stage. It's a live orchestra. It's about a 10-piece orchestra as well. Joshua Henry, the African-American composer, has composed an amazing score of 20 original songs. For the show, it is about 75 minutes with intermission, and I have a surprise for you.
You do?
Yes. Luis Salgado and Joshua, who have been in the show, send you this beautiful Amigo Duende shirt for you to proudly wear and proudly display. So there you go.
Nice. Thank you.
From Revolución Latina.
Thank you. Yes, this is the in color too.
There you go,
the
green
lime,
is
you know,
in.
If you saw the Olympics.
And
you know,
I also have a surprise for your viewers, Rina.
You do?
Yes, I do.
We love gifts.
I was actually given two family packs of tickets of 4 tickets each.
Oh.
To give for free.
Nice.
Now, this is part of a program that we have called Kids Beyond Broadway, which has already given about 600 free tickets to Amigo Duende. To communities citywide, many of them in the Bronx as well.
So I just want to make sure I got this right. It's 4 sets of family, so it's two sets of family tickets. Okay, 2 sets of 2 tickets.
Or 4 tickets.
Or 4 tickets.
For tomorrow.
Oh, so it's a full family, not just...
It's a full family.
That's nice.
So basically what we can do is that those people who call my cell phone and leave me a message with their name and phone number so I can call them back, we'll get the tickets. The number, you ready?
Yes.
It's 917-533-1247. Again, 917-533-1247. The first 2 calls that I get on my cell phone, please leave your name and number so I can call you back. We'll get the 2 family packs for tomorrow, Saturday afternoon and evening at El Museo.
Beautiful. And don't forget to mention that you got it by watching Open with Rina Valente.
Absolutely.
So that is awesome. That is such a wonderful gift that you're offering to our viewers, and I hope you guys take advantage of it. Feel free to call him now. I mean, you know, the idea is the first messages he gets are the ones who are going to win this fabulous offer of 2 sets of tickets for 4. 2 sets of tickets for 4 for a Broadway-style production happening at Museo del Barrio, Amigo Duende. So
very important, Revolución Latina has educational programming year-round. So if anyone out there would like the Revolución Latina programs to come into your school, come into your neighborhood, please check out our website, www.revolucionlatina.org. Send us an email there. We'll call you back and we'll figure out what will be the best way of bringing arts into your communities.
Right, and so Revolución Latina actually does these programs for kids, and just really quick so you guys get the gist of what Javier is saying, it's a program that is traveling now, and they're doing a lot of work in the Bronx, so if you're a school or someone who is familiar with the school or an after-school program of some sort, you know, reach out to them because their programs are definitely something to take advantage of. So thanks, Javier.
Thank you. Any
last words before we go?
Well, thank you, and thanks to all of the team at Open for being so supportive of Revolución Latina and Amigo Duende. I think it is very important, the kind of work you're doing, and if we continue to join forces, we will make a difference.
Yes, and that's what it's all about, making a difference. All right, beautiful. Thank you, Javier.
Thank you. Great to see you.
Thank you for the t-shirt, too. All right, for more on Amigo Duende, once again, you can check out the play itself during its run at El Museo del Barrio that's happening this weekend, people, October 4th through the 7th. October 4th through the 7th with two shows on Saturday and two shows on Sunday. The Museo del Barrio is located at 1230 Fifth Avenue at East 104th Street in East Harlem. And once again, before we go, if you call in right now, the first two people to call Javier at 917-533-1247 will win a set of tickets for four people to actually go check out the show, Amigo Duende. All right, we got to take a quick break, but we'll be right back with the people behind the third annual New York Latin Music Awards. But first, let's take a look at the National Voter Registration Day that is at Lehman College, where they collaborated with Hot 97 and NYC Votes to reach young people and encourage them to vote in election. Bronx reporter Sylvia Anglin tells us more.
In the most recent congressional primaries, the voter turnout in the Bronx ranged from the dismal 15.5% to the eye-opening 7.8%.
You know, there's 23 million eligible that are not even going to probably be registered this year, and that's why we're doing everything that we can to get information out to people and show up where they are, make it as easy and accessible as possible online. Joining huge collaborations. I mean, today is National Voter Registration Day. We've been working on this for over a year. We have 1,200 partnerships and over 900 events happening around the country. We're really trying everything that we possibly can to take excuses away from people.
So events like the Lehman Votes in conjunction with various voter registration groups are at the forefront of registering the young first-time voters.
I turned 18 this year. So I guess I'm pretty excited, you know. I've never done this before. I feel good. I actually feel like I'm doing something important, you know, for the future as well.
I think it is so important to vote simply because our, you know, people in the past, they fought so hard so that we can have the right to vote. So I feel it's so important to exercise their right to vote. And whatever happens, whoever is chosen and whatever happens while they're in office, whether it's good or bad, and if it's good, you can be prideful and say that you took part in that happening.
It's important to recognize that in New York City, there are potential voters who are in fact still in high school, and it's also important that these students are provided with the voter registration resources that they need to make an educated decision.
We, through the Voter Assistance Commission, work to try to make sure we try to get as much information as possible, and really encouraging our students to register, whether it's registering at a school site, or taking at least a voter registration form, or really just going to the Board of Elections or contacting 311. And I think it's extremely important, and I've always been involved from as a chair of the Voter Assistance Commission way back when, in making sure that our youth are encouraged to vote.
Students from various campuses and student organizations came out in a large force to encourage the youth to register to vote. The rates are alarming. History shows young people don't come out and vote in the numbers that they should. And through events like this one, held by Lehman Votes at Lehman College here in the Bronx, event organizers hope to register as many voters before the October 12th deadline. Reporting from the Bedford Park section of the Bronx, this is Sylvia Anglin for BronxNet.
Coming home can be hard if you're a veteran of Iraq or Afghanistan. You may feel like you're all alone. But you're not alone. At IAVA.org, your fellow vets are all around you. Join our free online community, get the resources you need, and connect to other vets who know where you're coming from. IAVA.org. We've got your back.
Cocina a la temperatura adecuada usando un termómetro para alimentos. Este año, 3.000 personas en Estados Unidos morirán por comer alimentos contaminados. Visita foodsafety.gov/español.
Hello, welcome back to the studio. Rina Valentin here. The New York Latin Music Awards, or Pionero Awards, are taking place at Hostos this year. And the third annual, that is, we've got the producer and two honorees here to tell us what you can expect. Please welcome Mario Torres, Eddie Montalvo, and Luis Manguel to the show. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Hello, and thank you for being with us again, Mario. And congratulations on this third anniversary, because it's 3 years. That means you're on a roll. You're going to rock it. Yeah. And not only that, I think it's an important award that is great to actually produce and recognizing people who have been out there in the game for a minute and, you know, not necessarily up for Grammys, right? Even though we have a Grammy winner here, a two-time Grammy, I might add, excuse me.
You know, it really, first I want to thank you, you know, for the opportunity of coming on your show and kind of, you know, letting folks know about this important cultural event. As you said, this is our third year. And I'm blessed to have the privilege and honor of working with really some of the most talented individuals in this industry. Last year, you know, Eddie Montalvo was the band that performed, you know, for the audience. This year, we have a legend in this industry, a family that really has been at the forefront of Latin music in this, you know, country. And that's Luis Manguel, who is going to be performing. And I'm really excited, not only because I get an opportunity to work with some of the, you know, biggest names in our community, but these are people that have been actively supporting our culture and our community and don't get the recognition at times that they deserve. And, you know, I have a dear friend, who you've interviewed a number of times, Señor Mike Amadeo, you know, from Amadeo Record Shop. And, you know, he has a saying that I think we can apply to the Pionero Awards, and that if you're going to recognize me or give me an honor, please give it to me while I'm alive.
Right.
So I can enjoy it.
Right. Give me a little ring and be that.
That's right. That's right. And so really one of the things that I try to do is recognize these artists who, for the most part, you know, we see on stage, we see them in our community, but we don't recognize them because they're not the band leader, they're not the singers, and these are people who collectively kind of have moved Latin music to where it's at today. I mean, you have, you know, we're honoring a fellow by the name of Pete Miranda, who has been in this business over 50 years.
Right.
Okay, has played with all of the top musicians. We have Gene Jefferson, a brother from Panama, who, if you look at his history and his contribution to not only Latin music, but to music overall, you know, has an impressive, you know, history and career in our community. So for me, you know, being able to produce this cultural event. It really is more than anything an honor and a privilege to work with these guys.
And to have it, have them acknowledged and be that, right? Yeah. I mean, you know, I met Luis Mangual, on the way in, mm-hmm. and you're such a humble man, you know? He's like, I don't know if I'm, you know, comfortable being in the forefront. And because you've been, you know, backup vocals, bongos, and things of that nature. What does this mean to you?
Well, it's a great honor. Got a little recognition. Been in the business for 45 years. Starts with my father, Jose Mangual. Started back in 1941 with Machito. I started playing back in 1967. Musician's life is very hard. Monetarily, it's not much happening. Very little recognition. But we do it for the love of the music.
How does one stay committed on that level, regardless of the lack of funds? Like, what motivates you to keep going?
The love of the music, the love of what you do, the instrument, the enjoyment and the pleasure you get out of entertaining people, seeing how they enjoy themselves, bringing pleasure to those who enjoy the music.
Now, Eddie, because you're a Grammy winner, right? Two-time Grammy winner. It's just a beautiful thing that just because you're a Grammy winner that you don't feel like you're superior, right?
No,
in
I
the
don't.
Sense that you're still part of this Pionero Award. And aside from being an honoree, you contributed. So how does one balance, like, one year you're hot and one year you're not being recognized?
Well, I mean, it's part of the territory, you know. I mean, you commit yourself to music. Our thing as musicians is we get joy of seeing people dancing, enjoying themselves. And God's been good to me. I can't complain. As a matter of fact, I just recorded an album that Ruben Blades and Joe Feliciano, and it just came out, and it's called Eddie Montalvo desde Nueva Yola, Puerto Rico. And they're playing it everywhere right now. So I've been blessed. I've been blessed. I mean, I got 42 years in the business. I've played with Pacheco, Hector Lavoe, Ruben Blades, Fania All-Star. Name it, more than 200 recordings. But again, it's a blessing of the Lord, you know, and I'm content with that. The day that the Lord says, hey, Eddie, it's over, I'm content.
That's interesting. The life of a musician is very interesting because...
And it's rough. It's not easy, Reina. It's not easy. I mean, you got to get up sometimes. I hate to say it, the times of the 70s when we used to get up at 1 o'clock in the morning. And I'm serious. To start in the Corso, or not Corso, but Copacabana at 2 in the morning. I mean, you're getting out of your house. Are you not Nevada snowing out there? And there you go, you know. Hey, Lord, please get me there, you know.
Right, right, right.
But you're committed. It's something that you love, you know. It's in your blood.
What does it feel like to win a Grammy?
Oh, it was great. I mean, I would never thought in the world that, you know, and a blessing, that I would win a Grammy. I mean, we won a Grammy with Ruben. Well, really, two Grammys. The last one was for the Todo Vuelven tour that we did with Ruben Blades. But, wow, that was a surprise. You know, all of a sudden they say, listen, Eddie, they want you guys to come down. Ruben says, hey, you know, Eddie, big competition. We don't think we're going to take it. All of a sudden, boom. You know, but I want to thank really Matt Productions because, you know, this man has really been out there busting, you know,
yes.
His brain out.
Right, right.
And all the respect is due to him.
Trying to make sure that all of you
right.
are recognized.
Exactly.
Not just the ones that are in the front singing, not just the ones that are running the show, but the ones
exactly.
like, you know, such as yourself, Luis Mangual, right? Because you've played with some heavy hitters as well, and you're a heavy hitter yourself, yet. Because you're more on the backside, you're not in the forefront, it's not necessarily, it's not overlooked by your fellow musicians,
exactly.
but viewers and audience members don't understand, like, the level of your caliber of talent based on, like, the way it flows, you know, you
right.
guys kind of jump from this band to that band, and only certain types of levels of players get to play with named people, and then you become names yourself, and the fact that you're bringing this all out and expressing it a little bit better than what I am.
But you know, one thing that is actually, you know, pretty fascinating, I think, kind of is speaks to the younger musicians, you know, that are, you know, trying to get into the music industry, is that both of these guys, okay, are examples of not only professional musicians, but people who both had not only an education, but also in terms of a career. I actually met Eddie, okay, when we both worked for Con Ed. And being able to recognize Eddie today, that's how we first met. He was a hero for Con Ed, had gone into a building where there was a fire and saved a family, and the company decided to recognize its, you know, its volunteers or employees. And so, you know, that's how far back I go with Eddie. You know, we go back to like 78. And so we've always maintained that relationship. That
I'm getting the eyes over here. I'm getting the eyes from the guys. Like, yeah, wow, yeah, it's in the 70s.
Yeah.
You're up there. But you all look fabulous, I got to say.
Thank you.
All
thank
of you.
You. Thank you.
All of you.
You know, Mr. Manguel, is, on the other hand, is someone who I've seen perform for many years, you know, with different groups. Obviously, his family is also recognized. And this really is a, you know, a group that has three generations. He's got his brother, Jose Manguel, okay, who's probably one of the premier singers, you know, in this industry. And he has his young son.
My son, Luis Jr.,
who is also going to participate, you know, with us. So, you know, we're privileged, or at least I'm privileged, you know, not only to get to know these guys and work with them, but to really have an opportunity to say to them, look, those are efforts that you've done over the years are being recognized, and not only by me and the people that kind of are involved in selecting who the winners are, but really by the community at large.
The people who have been following you and supporting you.
Definitely so. It's a very hard life. Most people don't realize musicians have another life besides the music life. We all work.
Mm-hmm.
Right. You have alternate forms of income.
Yes, definitely.
And that said, when is the Pionero Awards?
The Pionero Awards is Saturday, October 20th at Hostos Center on 149th Street, Grand Concourse. And it's at 7 p.m. And so we're inviting, you know, you obviously and your guests, people that are watching the show too.
Now we want to see you there now.
I'll be there.
Okay.
I'll be there. I will let you know that I'm there.
Okay.
Because I want you to shout me out.
Right? Okay, you got it.
So that's the pack. That's
you
the
got
pack.
It.
All right. Awesome. Awesome. All right. So that's October 27th.
No, 20th.
Ooh, Saturday. It's the weekend already. Yeah. October 20th.
7
at Hostos, in the presence of all these legends. Right. I'm so looking forward to it. I hope you guys are too. All right, well, we're out of time, guys.
Sure.
But thank you so much for taking time out of your multiple occupations to be here with us
and
bless our set. So thank you, really.
Thank
it's
you.
An honor.
Thank you so much, Lena.
All right, once again, for more on the New York Latin Music Pionero Awards, you can check out the Hostos website by going to hostos.cuny.edu/culturearts. And we'll be right back with Bobby C. and the Sports Roundup, so don't go anywhere.
This is Bobby C. reporting from Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, where our Week 4 recap begins here with the New York Giants and the Philadelphia Eagles. The Giants rallied in the fourth quarter and had plenty of opportunities to win the game, but the Eagles' defense shut down the Giants on a key late fourth quarter drive. We go inside the locker room for some rapid reaction with head coach Tom Coughlin.
We played hard. It was a tough ball game on both sides. I really did believe we would do some damage on kickoff return, and we did. We got ourselves great field position, and you would have thought with that kind of field position we would have had more points. Give them credit defensively for the job they did. Again, we gave ourselves a chance to win. We didn't win it.
The Philadelphia Eagles led 7-3 at halftime, and heading into the third quarter, took a 10-3 lead before Victor Cruz hit the end zone for the Giants as the Giants tied it up at 10-10. Heading into the fourth quarter, the Eagles took another lead, leading by three before Eli Manning connected with Bear Pasco. The Bear Pasco touchdown would give the Giants a 17-16 lead, but Alex Henry would strike again, connecting on another field goal for the Eagles as they took a two-point lead late in the fourth quarter with under 2 minutes to play. But the Giants on the final drive would storm all the way upfield, giving Lawrence Tynes an opportunity to kick the game-winning field goal. Two opportunities, though, 0-for-2 on third and fourth down as the Giants fall here in Philadelphia.
These games have come down to the fourth quarter, and you know, a play or two makes a difference in the game. And so, you know, you like to have the opportunity at the end with the ball to, with a chance to go win it. And we had that opportunity and, you know, did some good things, got in a position, but obviously didn't make enough plays to win the game.
The Giants have already turned their attention to next week against the Cleveland Browns as they return home to MetLife Stadium in the Meadowlands. Here is Justin Tuck and Eli Manning on Week 5 in the NFL.
I mean, we're not going to hang our heads about it. We'll go back and watch the tape, look at some things that we can improve on, and you know, come out next week and try to, you know, get the bad taste out of our mouth.
There's a lot of football to be played, and so you know, we still got a bunch of divisional games left. You know, we got Cleveland next week, and we got to get worried about that. So we got to just worry about, you know, winning each week, and you know, worry about getting better, improving on things, and you know, the divisional race will work itself out as you get later in the season.
It was a rough Sunday for the New York football teams back home in New York. The Jets fell 34-0 to San Francisco. Mark Sanchez had a rough day at the office. We go inside the locker room at MetLife to catch up with Mark Sanchez.
You know, his message there was really to look yourself in the mirror and ask yourself, how are you going to get better? And you know, if we all do that and really stick to it, come up with a quick plan here of how we're going to improve individually, you know, we can accomplish what we want to, what we set out to accomplish this year. So, you know, I'm sure a lot of guys will still be there working out. But, you know, he just wants to make sure guys let a loss like this sink in. Hopefully we never have to feel like this again.
That's your Week 4 wrap-up from Philadelphia. Final score again tonight here. Eagles 19, Giants 17 back home in New York. The Jets fall 34-0.
The Giants are winless in the NFC East as they prepare for Sunday's 1 p.m. kickoff with the Cleveland Browns at MetLife Stadium. Big Blue will also head into Week 5 once again without wide receiver Hakeem Nicks, a key playmaker on the offense who was sorely missed on that final drive in Philadelphia. Sunday will mark the third straight week without Nicks. Meanwhile, the Jets have lost arguably their best playmaker for the season. Wide out Santonio Holmes was a casualty of Sunday's loss to San Francisco. He will have surgery on his injured left foot. The Jets have signed journeyman wide receiver Jason Hill in an effort to help their receiving core. The Jets will take center stage on Monday Night Football, welcoming the undefeated Houston Texans. Tough matchup for the Jets. We shift gears from the NFL gridiron to the NBA, where training camps around the league open this week. The Knicks and the new Nets of Brooklyn got back to work. We caught up with some of your favorite Knicks on day one. Here's a look at Media Day at the Knicks training facility in Greenburg.
I feel great. You know, my body still feels really good. I did, you know, I worked extremely hard this off season to make sure I was strong and ready for this upcoming year. From that standpoint, I feel good. You know, so it's gonna be a good year for us. Our job is to continue to improve. You know, take it one game at a time and keep working toward that goal.
I'm about 2.5 to 3 weeks away. I haven't been cleared to practice yet, but still rehabbing. Still trying to get in shape. Whenever the doctors clear me, I'll be on the court playing 110%.
I think this is my opportunity to show people that I can play. I mean, I feel as I'm just as good as anybody else in the league, so I'm just going to show people that.
I'm in shape now, ready to go, and I got a big, big chip on my shoulder, so I look forward to the season. I'm definitely happy to be back in this New York Knicks jersey, for sure.
Forward center Rasheed Wallace will indeed come out of retirement to join this group. The four-time All-Star is 38, but feels like he still has something left that can help the orange and blue. The Knicks also announced yesterday that they will play the Detroit Pistons in London on January 17th. Time for some quick hitters. Here in the Bronx, the Yankees wrapped up the American League East
on Wednesday night. In a few, we'll go inside the locker room in the C-list for the champagne celebration. The Bombers open the postseason Sunday. They will face the winner of tonight's wildcard showdown between Texas and Baltimore. Boston's loss Wednesday night to the Yankees was the last for former Met manager Bobby Valentine. He's out in Beantown, fired on Thursday. And former Red Sox pitcher Curt Schilling may have to sell his famed bloodstained sock he wore during the 2004 ALCS to cover millions in loans for his losses in a video game company. A Yankee fan should buy it and burn it. Did I say that out loud? On the college gridiron, the Fordham Rams fell short to Lehigh last week, dropping the matchup 34-31 on the road. The Rams are 3-2 and will be back home Saturday at Rose Hill for Georgetown. On the ice, the NHL has scrapped the first 2 weeks of the regular season. No preseason, 2 weeks already off the slate in the NHL. Well, it's time for some bubbly. We hit the C-list and celebrate the AL East champs.
This is Bobby C. reporting from the Yankees clubhouse. It took 162 games, but the Yankees survived the marathon that is the baseball season to win the American League East. Here's the celebration. One word to describe what it means to win the American League East.
Amazing. You know, especially everything that we went through this year, having, you know, the adversity. It's just an amazing time.
After the grind of 162, how important was it for the Yankees to win the division?
I mean, that's big, especially the way it's all set up now. You know, to be the champs, it feels good. I feel like we deserve it because we worked our butts off all year and we grinded it out.
It just shows our character. I mean, we have such a great group of guys in here. We all pull for each other, and no matter what injuries we had or how many tough stretches we might have gone through, we never gave up hope and never gave up on each other, and that's why we're champs right now.
What is the emotions going through the Yankee clubhouse, knowing that it's taken so long just to get here?
You know what? We play hard all 9 innings. And you see, we score almost every inning. So we don't care about Baltimore or Tampa. We care about the Yankees and to win the division.
You know, the camaraderie in here is at an all-time high. And couldn't be better than just kind of cruising in the playoffs at this point, man. We got a lot of guys doing a lot of great things, man. So just to be able to sit in here, man, just watching these guys, man, popping champagne, dude, just enjoying it, man.
What does it mean to you to be here tonight?
It means the world. You know, from spring training, I said I wanted to be, you know, even the smallest piece to a winning puzzle. And, you know, it got us here 162 and winning the AL East.
It's the energy of the Bronx tonight. The stadium crowd was certainly behind the Yankees.
It's the great thing about it. Every night, you know, no matter if it's game 162 or game 52, it's definitely got a different vibe in the ballpark than anywhere else in the league. And just can't wait to see what it's like come a couple weeks from now.
It's been such a privilege and an honor to be over here for the past 4 years, man, and just enjoying this, bro. Like I said, NYC is party time, y'all. It's party time.
From one champion to another, we have a special sports corner on the program today, welcoming Rocky Bucano of the New York Gauchos to our studios for a sit-down on the latest and greatest from the basketball program. Rocky, welcome to the show.
You're welcome.
Quickly, the Yankees, what are your thoughts here? How are the Yankees going to do?
I think they'll probably do okay. Looks like their pitching is starting to come together. Their hitting is certainly there. So hopefully they go a little bit further than they've been going in the past couple years.
Yeah, definitely. They definitely have the talent. They have the players. They have the legends to do it. And we know that the Yankees have some great legends. And what about the Gauchos? Notable NBA alumni of the New York Gauchos. Here we go. Chris Mullin, Kimball Walker, Ed Pinckney, Stephon Marbury, Kenny Anderson, Dwayne Pearl Washington, Mark Jackson, Jamal Mashburn, Sonny Ata Gaines. And the list just keeps on going and going and going. 45 years. And you have a celebration coming up. The Yankees celebrated this week. You guys are celebrating as well. Tell us about the gala coming up on October 10th.
Well, like you said, it's our 45th anniversary, which is an incredible milestone for a youth basketball program. We are the premier AAU basketball program in the country. We started in 1967. So this year we get a chance to celebrate and honor one of our own, Chris Mullin. He's an NBA Hall of Famer. He's the only Gaucho to make it to the NBA Hall of Fame. And he's also a two-time Olympic gold medalist. So we are inducting him into the Gauchos Hall of Fame on Wednesday, October 10th.
Gauchos have become not only legendary for the basketball, but really a safe haven for children and kids in the Bronx. I know I love going to the gym. I think that place is as legendary as Yankee Stadium down there. So for you, what does this mean to have an event like this?
Well, it's great because all the proceeds from the gala goes into what we call our building fund. So the building fund basically helps us keep the doors open for the kids. It, you know, pays for the electricity. It supports our maintenance costs. And it just gives us the ability to, you know, help develop the kids in their academic and athletic potentials.
Chris Mullin, of course, a big-time name, as you mentioned, one of the best players to ever play the game of basketball. But some other big names on the list as well, including Stephen A. Smith, who's doing the emceeing.
Yes, Stephen A. Smith is our keynote speaker. It's great to have him. He jumped right on board. As soon as we made a call to his office, his assistant told us that he said he would be great, you know, more than happy to join us. We also have Councilwoman Maria Del Carmen Arroyo from Mott Haven. She's coming out to support, and she's one of our guest speakers. And we also have the chairman of the Bronx Chamber of Commerce, Joe Kelleher. So, you know, we have a great event plan for people who want to come out and support this program. We also have live entertainment by Byron Miller. He's a great musician. He performed with Luther Vandross, Roy Ayers, George Duke. So the live entertainment honoring Chris Mullin. We have a great food menu for people who are going to, you know, come out and eat. And we have a silent auction with some great sports memorabilia that was donated to us by Magic Johnson, Amari Stoudemire, the New York Knicks, and a lot of other folks.
So the event will be at the Prince George Ballroom Wednesday, October 10th. Tickets for the 8th annual gala, can be purchased for $300 and a table can be sponsored for $4,000. They should go to NewYorkGauchos.com.
That's correct.
Before we let you go, too, I want to ask you about this other thing you got going on, too, Kingsbridge Armory. Tell us a little bit more about that.
Well, we've teamed up with a real estate developer by the name of Young Woo. His company is called Young Woo Associates. In December of this year, the city released an RFP to redevelop the Kingsbridge Armory. There were 10 plans that were submitted. His plan is become part of the finals. There's only two plans left, the Young Woo plan and another plan that intends to make the Kingsbridge Armory the biggest skating rink in the country. But Young Woo basically came to the Gauchos, and he wants to help us expand to the Kingsbridge Armory to reach more kids.
Very exciting news here in the Bronx.
Absolutely. Couldn't be
great. Congratulations. I really appreciate you coming on the show. And we encourage everyone to get involved, not only at the Armory, but also with the Gauchos and celebrating their 45th anniversary.
Thank you.
Thanks, Rocky. Appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Open will continue after this with our Open Artist Spotlight. Don't go anywhere.
Nice, Dad. Nice, Dad. Nice, Dad.
Charles!
Nice, Dad.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of siblings in foster care who'll take you just as you are.
Hey, how's it going?
Sir, are you okay?
What? Oh, this? It's probably nothing. I'm sure it'll go away.
Go away? But, sir, that can't be good.
No, it's cool. Really.
Do you want a napkin or something?
Everything's fine. Thanks.
You wouldn't ignore this. So why ignore the signs of a stroke? At the first warning signs, call 911 immediately. Because time lost is brain lost.
Separate raw meats from other foods by using different cutting boards. 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back to Open. The lights are shining. You know what that means. It is now time for our Open Artist Spotlight.
The Open Artist Spotlight is made possible in part with public funds from the Bronx Council on the Arts through the New York State Council on the Arts.
Sports Decentralization Program.
Please welcome to the stage Alma Moyo and the musicians of Bon Plenazo 2012. Prosperity and love. Happy Hispanic Heritage Month.